The last section of chapter 5 talks about incident management. The incident is any difference between actual and expected outcome in our system. So if I'm expecting my system or my application to behave in a certain way and it behaved in another way, this is called an incident. We should investigate this incident and it may turn out to be a defect or bug. So this is a bug report or an incident report template that is written in Microsoft Excel. These are the most important items that should be written inside your incident report. So first, the ID. Each incident report or bug report has a unique ID with it. The name. So here this bug is called cart unable to add new item to my cart. So here the tester was testing an e-commerce website and he can't add items to the cart. The reporter is the tester who found this bug, is Mike. He submitted it on 3rd of April. Then the bug overview, its summary. Let's read the summary. When my cart contains one item, I am unable to add a second item via the add to cart button on a product page. So he says that when his cart contains one item, he can't add a second item, okay? And then the URL. The URL of the page where this bug appears, the screenshot of the bug, the environment, this is for traceability and for configuration management, the platform is Macintosh, the operating system is OS 10, the browser in which he found the bug details, first the steps to reproduce, and this is very important, how to reproduce this bug. First, he added one item to the cart, then he went to the product via the search. Then he added a new item to the cart and he says see screenshot because the screenshot contains this bug. Then he went to the cart. The expected result is that the cart should contain two items after adding the second item, but the actual is it contains only one item. There is no description and there is the severity and the priority. The severity and the priority are very important in the bug. The severity is how much severe is this bug. When this bug happens, what is its impact and danger on our system? We can say that it is critical, major, or minor. The priority is how urgent this bug is to fix. So this is an important bug, even if it is not severe. So for example, if the logo of the company is not appearing in a correct way or it has a grammatical error, this bug is not severe, okay? Me as a user, I can do anything in this app or this website without feeling that my experience is bad. But this bug has a very high priority. Why? Because this is the logo of the company. For the advertisement and so on, this is a high priority bug. So we need to fix it as soon as possible, even if it is not severe. Then let's talk about the bug life cycle, and this is an important aspect in software testing. So first, there is a new bug and we wrote a bug report like this one. Then we assign this bug to the appropriate developer who is responsible for it. He opens it and he should fix it, okay? After he fixes it, we begin retesting. He waits for us to begin retesting and then my team leader verifies it and it's closed. I may reopen it because it is not fixed and he may tell me that this bug is not his responsibility. We talked about these four cases in chapter 2 while we were talking about retesting and regression testing. So this is the end of chapter 5. When you study chapter 5, you will feel that it is very easy, okay? But the problem is the questions that come on it in the exam are harder than other chapters. So I recommend you that after finishing this series, watch the videos about sample exams that we will solve together on the channel, okay? There we will solve questions on chapter 5 and we will talk about why did we solve these questions in this way. So this would be a good training for you in preparation for the exam. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like the video and share it between your colleagues and friends. Thank you and goodbye. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.